Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I have a collective haul for you. I have a few things from the Sephora VIB sale. I have Yeezy Gap, Justin Bieber merch, Drew. I also have Nike and North Face. So if you are interested, continue watching. I'm going to start off with what I got from the Sephora VIB sale. I did not get a lot this time around. I wanted to keep my purchase to a minimum and just get what I need. I think I'm finally done with trying out different skincare products because I think I have found what my skin needs. So I'm done testing things out, and the things that I got is really just products that I'm in love with right now, and I just needed a restock on them. So the first thing I knew that I was gonna get is the Merit Beauty Clean Lash Mascara. This is my absolute favorite mascara of all time. I find that with a lot of mascaras that I've tried in the past, it's just like really clumpy and just doesn't really do much for my lashes, even if it says that it's volumizing or lengthening. It just never really worked for me until Merit. I don't think I'm ever going to go back to another mascara because, just like with skincare, I'm also done with testing out makeup products. So if you guys haven't tried this, make sure you try this out, and let me tell you, you will not regret it. I also got the Super Goop Unseen Sunscreen. The first time I tried it was actually in Mexico. I bought the mini travel size just to try out, see if I like it, and I honestly absolutely love it. This sunscreen is a game changer. It's not like those white pasty sunscreens that leave like a white cast over your skin. This is a game changer, and I love that like when I was on the beach, I was able to reapply it without even looking in the mirror or having to worry about missing a white spot on my face or anything like that. I am in love with it, and I had to buy the value size, I believe that's what it's called, the biggest size. I love it. If you haven't tried out this Super Goop Unseen Sunscreen, it's definitely worth a try. I also got the Cinema Secrets Makeup Brush Cleaner. I've been using this one for the past 3 to 4 years now. Before using this product, I honestly hated washing my brushes because I just felt like it took so long just to clean them, and also just so long to dry as well. And once this was introduced to me by my lash lady, it's just been such a game changer. My brushes dry quickly. This product is rinse free, and it's also very conditioning to your brushes as well. It doesn't leave your brushes feeling dry, and it also smells really, really good. I know I said that I was done testing out makeup products and also skincare products, and I was trying to keep things to a minimal, but I did want to treat myself to the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk Lip Kit. This is in Intense. So my best friend actually has this kit, and I believe it's in the medium shade, whatever number 2 is. The medium shade was a little too light for me, maybe because of my tan, it just really didn't work out. But there was no difference, but I really loved how it felt on my lips. So I did wanted to give it a try in the Intense shade. I haven't tried it out just yet, but I just hope that it will be a bit darker and will show up on my lips a little bit more. If not, then that is an L on my part, and this is what happens when you just want to try things out and it just doesn't work. So if this doesn't work, well then a lucky friend of mine is gonna get this, whoever it is. That was all that I got from the Sephora VIP sale. So we're gonna move on to some Justin Bieber merch. If you do have me on Instagram, you obviously know that I went to the Justin Bieber concert. It was very spontaneous, actually. We weren't actually planning on going to the concert. We just bought tickets the night before because we knew that we would regret not going. He is going to have another concert June 7th, I believe, but we just don't really know what's gonna happen between like now and June 7th. So we wanted to make sure that we actually went. So of course we did go and we got some merch. So I picked up the Peaches hoodie. This is very similar to his Purpose Tour merch where it says staff up at the front, but at the back, instead of having the concert name on it at the back, which was the Justice Tour, just like what he did with the Purpose Tour, he had the Purpose Tour name on it. This time it has Peaches going from the top to the bottom and Justin Bieber just right smack in the middle. I also got this Peaches t-shirt. We actually didn't get this at the concert, but we did get it from his merch website. I believe they did have it at a few other concerts, so I'm not too sure if we just got to the concert late and they've already sold out, but we did see online that at other concerts they did have this t-shirt. So we did get this one online and it was like only $35, which would actually be cheaper, or is cheaper than buying it at the concert anyways. So got it for a steal. It's really, really cute. Ask me where I would wear this, and I honestly can't tell you where I would wear this t-shirt, but honestly, it's just so different, and I really just could not pass up on this t-shirt. Moving on to more Justin Bieber, I picked up this Drew House long sleeve. This one is actually in collaboration with the Toronto Maple Leafs. So down one sleeve, it says Maple, and then on the other, it says Leafs. So I picked up this one from the Toronto Real Sports, and I'm actually just noticing that on the collar, it says a little Sutton. It says pride, courage, honor, going all around, which is kind of cool. Had to pick this up because I was just in need of something that was Toronto Maple Leafs. Right now I just have the jersey, but thought this was really, really cool since it was a collaboration with Drew House. Enough about Justin Bieber. We are done talking about Justin Bieber. We are moving on to Yeezy Gap. I purchased the Yeezy Gap sweater in black. This is in the size medium. I know it's kind of hard to just like see what it is, but it is a hoodie and it has a kangaroo pouch up here at the front. This sweater is honestly great quality. It's very thick. It would be great for a cold spring day, winter days, cold weather in general. This will keep you warm. One thing that is different about the sweater is that it is cropped. So even for men's, this is actually just like a unisex sweater, so for both for women and men. If you are over 5'5", this will definitely be cropped on you. Renee actually got this sweater as well, but in the color blue. He's 6'1", and you can definitely tell that it is cropped. On me, I think you can also see that it is cropped. It hits my waist, and definitely if I raise my arms, you will see that the sweater does go up, but because the sweater is loose, I actually like it a lot. I find that with a lot of women's sweater, when it is cropped, it is a little more slimming, which is not really what I like anyways. So this is kind of like the perfect cropped hoodie for me. So that was all the clothes that I have bought recently. I only have two more items left in this haul. And over here, I have a pair of Nike Air Force Ones. And of course, I got them in all white because it is a staple. And the ones that I have had for the past 2 years have gone yellow. The soles have gone yellow, so it was definitely time. I don't know why they turned yellow. Maybe because they've been in the closet for like the past year and it hasn't really been getting enough air, oxygen, that it just turned yellow. Or maybe it was just time to get a new pair in general. So here they are. How clean are these? I always pick up a pair like almost every single year, but last year I did not pick up a pair because I had a pair of New Balances that looked exactly like the Air Force Ones, and I wanted to take a break from the Air Force Ones, so bought a pair of New Balance looking ones, and now I'm back with a new pair. And these babies, hopefully I can take care of them, but I can guarantee you and next year I will be buying another pair. And lastly, I picked up this North Face bag. It's a shoulder bag, but it is also a backpack as well. So I plan on using this for the days I plan on going to the gym after work. I like that it can be a backpack. So when I do walk to the gym from work, it's just easy for me to carry. And I don't have to, you know, have something on my shoulders after a long day at work. So that was mainly the reason why I like this bag. Also because on the side of the bag, it has a water bottle holder on both sides. I think I'm going to be keeping my shoes and my gym clothes in here. Obviously separately bagged because you can't pack your shoes and your clothes together. They just can't be touching. So obviously in separate bags, they will be in this laptop pocket. And so that was the reason why I got this bag, also because it is waterproof as well. And I'm also just noticing that there is a pocket at the front too. So there you guys have it. That was my little collective haul. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below if you are just trying to keep things to a minimum these days. I'm honestly trying. I know it doesn't seem like it because this is a haul, but I'm really trying to be more minimal with what I buy. And if you guys haven't already subscribed, go do that right now, and we will see you in the next video. Bye guys.